If you want something out of life, if you want to change yourself, if you want to acquire something, if there's some goal that you want to reach, that is really not easy, as some people will make us feel. That living your dream, changing your behaviors, overcoming negative habits, it's challenging. It's hard. Most people go through life never discovering what their talents are. Most people never develop their talents. They have skills and abilities, but if you don't nurture them, if you don't develop them, they will never serve you. Your gifts can take you many places if you develop your gifts. Most of us don't like to do those things that come easy to us. I've always loved to talk to people. I decided, taking this advice, to develop my skills as a speaker. And my gift has developed and it developed and has taken me many places. You have something that you brought to the universe. And that if you decide that my life deserves my developing this, what I do well, and becoming the best at it and mastering myself and seeing what I have within me, if you decide to drop your buckets where you are and develop your gifts, I grant you, you'll never ever be without. I grant you that your gifts will take you places that will literally amaze you. I grant you that if you begin to work to develop your gifts, you'll develop a strong sense of happiness. You'll get a larger vision of yourself, because part of beginning to get a larger vision of yourself, all of us need some area of our lives where we can have a feeling of competence. That people know when they think about this area, that's something you do. That you eat and sleep that, and that you do that, and people know it, and you know it, and you know that you know that you know this. If you don't know anything else, you know this. Can you tell I know what I'm doing? Oh, hello. You know this. So you've got to work on it. When other folk are having a good time, you've got to have the strength of character to concentrate, to read, to digest information. If you decide, in any particular area that you're concerned about, to make a conscious, deliberate, determined effort to read one book a month in that area, in 5 years, you'll be among the top 5% experts in the world. I read a minimum of 2 books a week. The average American reads only 1 book a year. If you decide that area that you love, that you are going to master that particular area, in this era of accelerated change, overwhelming complexity, and tremendous competition, as you begin to develop and expand your skills and your talents and your vision of yourself, you will always be in control of your destiny. The next thing is, whatever it is that you want to do, you want to do it massively. I have a friend who was telling me that his sales were down. I said, well, how many phone calls you make a day? He said, 25. I said, double them. Make 50 or 75 or 100. He said, oh man, that's just too much. I said, what do you mean too much? You behind on your bills? You talking about too much? You know one way to get back on your feet real quick is to miss 2 car payments? You talking about you're tired? There's no competition out here. Decide that you're going to push yourself. Most people won't do that. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know the human spirit is powerful. There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit. They asked Benjamin Disraeli, a man who became the head of a country at a time when Jews were not allowed out after 10 o'clock. He said, how did you do it? How do you achieve against such great odds? He said, nothing can resist the will of a people that will stake even their existence on the extent of their purpose for good. That when you have a made-up mind, when you decide that you want to do something, I was reading something the other day, he said, the power to hold on in spite of everything, the power to endure, this is the winner's quality. The hunger, the ability to face defeat again and again without giving up. This is a winner's quality. You have that quality within you. When you're hungry, you don't care about the facts. You don't care about the odds. Doug Williams played for the Washington Redskins, quarterback. John Elway of the Denver Broncos in the Super Bowl. Everybody was talking about Elway, Elway. After the Super Bowl, when Doug Williams made a historic passing game, I asked him, said, how were you able, in spite of all of that negative publicity saying that you couldn't win, how did you do it? He said, I ignored my critics. I just didn't pay any attention to them. I ignored myself because they kept on saying it so much. There were times I doubted whether or not I can do what I needed to do. There's a Doug Williams in everybody here. There's greatness in you. And you've got to learn how to tune out the critics outside and the critic inside. And since I'm going to do this, I'm going to harness my will. And I'm not going to let anything stop me. I deserve this. I'm going to do it until. And this friend, I told him, said, start increasing your calls. I said, I make 100 calls a day. I got a callus in my ear. My ear is kind of dark. You can't see it, but it's there. His sales have increased. He's working harder now. The other thing is that if you want something, you have got to be relentless. You've got to learn how to become resourceful. You've got to learn how to become creative. When crises strike in your life, and in the Chinese language, crises mean danger, but it also means opportunity. And this is an opportunity for you to grow. And you've got to be so relentless, regardless of what comes down the pike, that you're always looking for a way to get over, always looking for a way that you can break through, always looking for a way that you can win, always looking for a way that you can strike a telling blow. And pretty soon, I think there's some people watching us in the universe that say, wait, let's call a meeting over here. You know that guy Mustafa, look at him down there. He won't stop, just that fool, oh no, he can't get over. Look here, why don't we do this? Let him go and let's mess with somebody else. Shit. Let him go on through. Life will just get tired of whipping you sometimes. And just say, let's just let this one go. I believe this. Now, nobody's told me this, but I just kept on kicking. I didn't have sense enough to stop. I was intelligently ignorant. I didn't know what I couldn't do. So I just tried anything. And the fascinating thing about life, because you can't get out of it alive, you might as well have a good time, you know? You might as well have a good time. Live your life with passion, with some drive. I was giving a seminar the other day, and I mentioned that I was going to do some training in August with some young teenagers and take about 100 away to a 2 or 3 day camp and wipe them out. Been working on this. So after the speech, one of the parents walked up to me and said, Mr. Brown, I'd like for you to do something for my son. He's not motivated. I said, I wonder why. I wonder what's wrong with him. He had no fire whatsoever. See, what you do speaks so loudly, folk can't hear what you're saying. And so if you don't have any fire, you know, you've got to watch the people, the relationships that you develop, have people of kindred mindsets. If you're around folk who are dead and negative all the time, they will affect you. You want people that are around you that have smiles on their faces, looking good. I was telling a group last week, Abraham Lincoln refused to hire a guy because of his face. They said, but the guy can't help it. He said, anybody over 30 is responsible for their face. If you have some depressing face looking at you every day, it affects your blood pressure. Keep these dad faces away from you. It's contagious. This is serious. So you've got to watch your countenance, watch your face, have an uplifted expression, watch your body posture. All of these things affect you psychically. You got to be the kind of person that you are fearless. Fearless. Folk leave fearless people alone. There's some people walk through a neighborhood and every dog in the neighborhood would bark at them. But there's some people come through and ain't nobody gonna mess with this. You are unstoppable. And because you are unstoppable, because you've got power that you haven't even begun to use yet, you owe it to yourself to release your brakes. How many of you have had the experience of pulling out of your driveway and you mashed on the accelerator and the car was just going, and couldn't move, and you mashed harder and it couldn't move, and then you discovered you had your emergency brakes on? And then you release those emergency brakes and it goes, choo! Have you ever had that experience before? Most of us go through life with our brakes on, holding back, not giving all that we have, not sharing all of ourselves. Most of us go to our graves still holding on rather than releasing it. What are some of those things that keep us from releasing it? Because of past experiences, past defeats, past pain. We look back, well, it didn't work out then. It probably won't work out now. Many people get confused their performances with who they are. They are. I was reading Pat Riley, the coach of the Los Angeles Lakers. But you're gonna like this quote here. After the Trailblazers had blown them out of the water, and I'm sure he said this last night, they asked him, how do you feel? He said, tonight we were exposed for what we are right now.